Here's Ortega. Oh, he's in a marvellous first half. Cross to the back post, but again it's too long. And retrieved by Crespo, who then left his foot out to trip Vidigal, did he? No, the whistle's not gone. Still it hasn't. Here's Morales. Well, it flashed perhaps a foot and a half wide of the post, but he would have been disappointed in the goalkeeping of Nuno if he'd been beaten from that sort of range. Vidigal trying to pick out Rui Jorge. Alfonso Martins, who skipped away from close attention. Here's Nuno Gomes. Alfonso Martins! Well, the Portuguese crowd here in the Sanford Stadium finally have something to applaud. Timed the pass just right for Alfonso Martins to remain onside, and it forced Caballero to come very quickly off his line. And the camera's not yet given a goal to record. Seven is Lopez. Crespo going to the back post, it's over the keeper. He couldn't grow tall enough. But again, the threat was carried by a better cross. Lopez does well to make the marker, aware that his striking partner Crespo had gone to the back post. Grow. Nuno Gomes, there's no whistle. Here's Almeida. And that's aimed at Crespo. Well, he left his foot there, Crespo. And that'll be a free kick. Hesitate to make absolutely certain. And in the end, they didn't. The first, the shot from Crespo, which brought a good save. It cannoned out perfectly for Lopez. He could have hit it harder than that, and he gave Alfonso time to get across and cut it out. And we're deep now, added on time at the end of this first half, still goalless. Ortega, who's carried the most threat, now Lopez, faced by Alfonso. Oh, there's two there, Crespo, yes, at last. It's been a long time in coming. We're 10 minutes into the second half. But Argentina have scored Crespo's fourth goal of the tournament. The new young star of Argentine football is currently with River Plate, their top goal scorer, but will transfer to Parma in Italy after this tournament. And he's put his nation one up in the semi-final. Yes! 2-0 Argentina. You can't fault the finish, but you've really got to look and admire the way it was teed up for him by Ortega. The little man who's looked a real genius. Receives the ball with his back to goal. He knew instinctively where he was and where to put it. The left foot to knock it forward, and look at the room that he's got. Placed it just outside the dive of Nuno, who may have got a fingertip to it. ...62 minutes gone. Argentina lead in the semi-final 2-0, and we're halfway to the dream final. They chipped it up. They're beginning to blend. They're beginning to find each other in a manner which really threatens to unhinge Portugal. Crespo trying to return the favour to Ortega. A cheeky little chip up. I don't think it would have gone in, but Lopez was lurking anyway. This is number four, Zanetti. 15, Bacedas. Crespo. Ortega. Another magic moment. Just into the side netting for the space in front of him, but it was so quickly closed. Or was it? Still Vidigal! Oh, off the woodwork! Well, now in their last 15 minutes of need and desperation, Portugal are committing players forward. Vidigal, who's come to support Domingues and Nuno Gomes, and that's the closest that they've come. Gallardo dispossessed. 13 is Vidigal. Rui Jorge forward. Now they've got Nuno Gomes coming to the near post. Here he is! He's got a score! It's a great save by Cavalheiro. Nuno Gomes. Argentina, led by Daniel Passarella and Gallego, are into the Olympic final in the football tournament. Argentina, comfortable winners by two goals to nil. Both the goals coming in the second half from their number nine, Crespo, to take his total for the tournament to five. But we wonder now who their opponents will be for the Olympic gold medal. Brazil to play Nigeria here tomorrow night. And what a tasty prospect that is. Argentina perhaps against Brazil. Nigeria wouldn't be a disappointment, but I'm sure the neutrals would want to see South America's big two